Hello, B here, and welcome back to Integrated Physics and Chemistry. Have you ever tried to eat a lemon? If you have, you probably made a really silly face from the sourness of it. Lemons taste sour because they contain citric acid. When washing dishes, have you ever noticed how the plate gets slippery when you add the soap? That is because soap is a base. Sour taste is a common property of acids, and feeling slippery is a common property of bases. Before we get started, let's look at our goals for this lesson. By the end, you'll be able to identify key properties of acids and bases. Use the Arrhenius definition of acids and bases to identify if a compound is an acid or a base. Name acids and bases. Acetic acid, citric acid, ascorbic acid, and carbonic acid. These are all acids that you can probably find in your kitchen. Do you know where? Acetic acid is vinegar, citric acid is lemon juice, ascorbic acid is vitamin C, and carbonic acid causes bubbles in sparkling water. There are multiple ways that you can define an acid. But in this course, we are going to use the Arrhenius definition. In this definition, acids are defined as compounds that increase the hydrogen ion concentration in a solution. Usually, these compounds are ionic compounds, like HCl, where the positive ion is an H+ ion. The more hydrogen ions in the solution, the higher the concentration of hydrogen ions, and therefore, the more acidic the solution will be. I want you to think about lemon juice again. We already talked about its sour taste. Can you think of any other properties? Have you ever noticed that lemon juice is sold in plastic containers, not metal cans? That's because acids, like the citric acid found in lemon juice, are highly corrosive when in contact with metals. Other key properties of acids are that they conduct electricity and are corrosive when in contact with fabric, skin, and metals. Just a friendly reminder, though, don't ever test for an acid using taste, as many acids are dangerous to our bodies. Sodium bicarbonate, sodium hydroxide, and calcium hypochlorite. These are all bases that you might have in your house. Sodium bicarbonate is baking soda, sodium hydroxide is found in drain cleaner, and calcium hypochlorite is found in bleach. Just like when discussing acids, there are a few different definitions of bases. Again, we will focus on the Arrhenius definition of bases that defines bases as compounds that increase the hydroxide ion concentration in a solution. Usually, these compounds are ionic compounds where the negative ion is an OH-1 ion. The more hydroxide ions in the solution, the higher the concentration of hydroxide ions, and therefore, the more basic the solution will be. Like acids, bases conduct electricity, but that is where the similarities end. Some common properties of bases include feeling slippery to the touch, a bitter taste, and they do not corrode metals. Once again, never test for a base by taste, as most bases are dangerous for your body. What do you notice about the formulas for these acids? They all have hydrogen as the first element in the compound. This makes the rules for naming acids simple. Let's use this flowchart to determine the name of these acids. HCl. There are only two elements, so we add the prefix hydro, and then we change the ending of the second element in the compound to IC and add the word acid. So, HCl is called hydrochloric acid. What about H2SO4? It has three elements, so we have to look at our polyatomic ion chart from Unit 4. Looking at that chart, we notice that the polyatomic ion is called sulfate. Since it ends in ATE, we change the name to IC and add the word acid. There is no prefix when the acid contains more than two elements. Therefore, H2SO4 is sulfuric acid. Okay, try HNO2 on your own. There are three elements, so we have to look at the name of the polyatomic ion on the polyatomic ion chart. NO2 is nitrite. So, according to our flowchart, we change the ending to OUS. Add the word acid, and there is no prefix. This means HNO2 is nitrous acid. What about bases? Look at the formulas for these bases. Do you notice a pattern? They all end in OH. This is another polyatomic ion, hydroxide. To name a base, you name the metal and then add the word hydroxide. For example, NaOH is sodium hydroxide. CaOH2 is calcium hydroxide. What about LiOH? Lithium hydroxide. As we went through the lesson today, we learned the properties of acids and bases and how to identify and define them. Then we discussed how to name acids and bases. In our next lesson, we will continue to learn more about these unique and interesting compounds. Until next time, remember, the universe is vast and full of surprises, so never stop exploring. I'll see you next time. Hey!